Hello fellow dog fanciers, welcome back to another video. I hope you had a wonderful week and that there is an even better weekend to come. Today's video is a request from two of my wonderful subscribers, and because I don't have any Whippet Puppies at the moment, I am going to try and work with what I have here, the best of my abilities, in order to show you what I mean with everything that I'm going to say. One day, when we happen to have puppies again in this home, I'm going to remake the video accordingly so that I can show it even better, but for now, as I said, I'm going to work with what I have. Before we get started, please do subscribe if you haven't already, because there are many hot topics regarding dogs and animals that will be coming up. Also, if you're on Facebook and you're curious about all kinds of breed, dog show, dog sports, news, then I highly encourage you to join Daily Dogs. It's a free online magazine. You don't have to pay anything to post your news or to look at news there. Let's get into the video. So to start with an important disclaimer, Whippet Puppies are not that different from other puppies. However, there are some specifics which I'm going to cover in this video. And by the way, if my voice sounds a little bit low, that's because 15 minutes ago I was about to drown myself while drinking water. So excuse that, please. So let's start with where you're getting your puppy from. This is very important, and please avoid backyard breeders and puppy mills at all cost. Later in time, I'm going to make a video exposing why puppy mills and backyard breeders are bad, which is kind of logical, but many people have no idea. But basically, responsible breeders tend to socialize their puppies very well, which means that you will be already getting a puppy with a very stable physical and psychological foundation. So most of you probably know that one of the things that Whippets are very famous for is that they don't sleep on the floor or on any hard surfaces. So prepare yourself with a lot of soft blankets, soft beds, and also cave beds. And if you don't know what it is, it's basically a dog bed with a cover over it, which helps the Whippet or the dog, because some other dogs like them too, to cover themselves with a blanket without you having to do it for them. These are very cozy beds, Whippets love them, and most probably it's one of the must-haves when it comes to preparing for a Whippet. Just be prepared that even though you've bought everything specifically for that puppy, it might end up preferring your bed and your couch. Whippets are also very smart, as I have mentioned on several occasions before, and that shows from the earliest of age. They can also be very naughty and destructive, and you should be prepared that this is something that might go on until they turn the age of 18 months. So make sure that you have secured the area where your puppy will spend most of its time, and be ready to have at least one pair of eyes on that puppy while it's awake. Remove cables, any dangerous item, and also items that are dear to you, because they will most likely get destroyed if your puppy gets their hands on it, or rather their teeth on it. And in case you doubt whether a specific object is dangerous or not, remove it and secure it just to be sure. Regardless of what your goal is going to be, whether that's going to be dog shows, obedience, agility, any kind of other sport, or just 100% non-sporting companion, start training early. Take some time to schedule in mental exercise accordingly. Whether you're going to teach them to sit, lay down, to be stacked, which is more for show dogs, to wave, to bring you objects. It doesn't matter what it is, but it's important that you do it from an early age. And when you do whatever exercise, the moment you see them lose interest, just stop. Keep them happy, arm yourself with all the treats in the world. Make it a fun game and not an obligation. Discipline, of course, is an inseparable part of owning almost any type of pet. With that said, it is of course also important for Whippets that anyway have a mind of their own already. The words no and leave it will be what will be leaving your mouth 90% of the time, so be prepared for that. And this will go on until your puppy learns not to put everything in its mouth and not to touch every single forbidden object. And just know that when you go outside for a walk, almost every single thing will be a target. The sticks, the leaves, cigarette butts, insects. Just as an indicator, they tend to outgrow the eating everything stage around the age of 10 months and the destroying everything stage around 15 months. And because I mentioned going outside, this brings me to the next topic, which is socializing. So because Whippets are very sensitive and they need very active socialization since an early age, I recommend that the moment your puppy completes all its vaccinations and your veterinarian gives you a green light for going outside, start going on adventures. Do not hesitate, start exploring the world, go in parks, walk around in the city, visit different areas, meet other dogs and people. Go on car rides, whatever is necessary to work towards the perfect socialization of that puppy. And if at the beginning, when you start doing all these things, they seem not confident enough or they feel unsure and maybe a little bit scared, don't worry, don't stop. Keep it going and in no time you will see them building confidence by the day. And believe me, it's so nice to see. So because of their sensitive nature, Whippets are prone to separation anxiety. They don't like to be alone, and if you have other dogs, it will be so much easier because they will feel that they have some comfort and some company. But if the puppy is your only dog, teach them that it is perfectly fine to be alone sometimes and start with that early. So just when you're about to leave your house or the room or whatever the case is and the puppy has to stay alone, provide them with some good chew toys so that they have their mind busy for a long time. And that is how they're going to associate you leaving the room, the house, whatever, with something very pleasant. So basically, these are all the specific things which I can explain without having to demonstrate. And I really wish I had a younger puppy here so that I could demonstrate leash training, trick training, discipline, everything. But unfortunately, I don't have a Whippet here that can trick you that it's a puppy. Regardless, I have promised one day I will remake this video. Last but not least, good job for making the decision of owning a Whippet. Congratulations, you're about to become a slave. Because every Whippet owner knows that Whippets are so great at manipulating us and also at getting what they want. And those who don't know it yet, when you get a Whippet, you will be trained in no time. And this was all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful weekend and I will see you next Friday with another video. Bye-bye!